A lot of y'all have asked me about the course that I learned in Ayurveda and what are the simple practices that you can do to really, really transform, or, you know, simple steps that you can start with. Now, if I have to just tell you five things that you perhaps must start with, I think the first one is always, always drink water while you are seated. I used to drink a lot of water, but I used to keep walking around and drinking, or, you know, when I'm on a call, I would drink water. But now I mindfully sit down and drink water, and it's brought in so much awareness within me that I think that is very, very, that's very, very transforming as well. The second one is always drink water at room temperature and make sure that it's closest to your body temperature. I know a lot of you guys would love drinking cold water and feel like that's the only one that makes you feel happy, satiated, whatever. Honestly, this one was an easy change for me to make because I never could quench my thirst with cold water. For me, that was never the thing. So it was much easier for me to make this shift, but now I consciously make it a point that the water is more warm than at room temperature, or it's closest to room temperature or what my body temperature is. The third one, which is very, very important, is always have a bath and eat your food. And in the mornings, again, this is a great biohack which I've learned over a period of time, is that I always have my morning showers with cold water and the evening ones with warm water. Morning ones typically, and it's a great biohack, is to have with cold water, and I'm someone who feels cold very fast. So for someone like me, what I do is I always have a shower soon after, or, you know, once my body has finished sweating on his back at room temperature, I have a cold shower. And that is typically because I feel like your focus and concentration is much higher and better when you have a cold shower in the morning. So that's number three, but always shower and then eat, because it ignites the agni in your body and your digestive juices will flow and you will digest your food much, much faster. The fourth one, if I was to ask and make you all to make that change, is to one, eat in silence, eat mindfully. And you know, if you're following me and you see my stories, you always ask me this question that how do you not eat more than that one roti, or how do you not go for taking, how do you eat so little? Honestly, it's not eating that little, but it's being very conscious of what you're eating, right? So, typically, if it's one roti, you always tear one piece, and then off that one piece, see if you can make two more pieces, and then try to eat. Try and chew as much as you can. I know 32 times sounds a lot, but even if you can start with eating more mindfully, eating slower than you usually do, it will make a significant amount of change. The fifth thing, which is fairly simple to do, but I think that it's made a significant difference to how I look at food, is not to mix milk and salt together. Now, what often happens is that we always look at something's not right with me, or this food did not suit me, by assuming that either we can't digest it, or we get an upset tummy, or we throw up, right? Those are the two ways or two measures that we assess whether this food suited me or did not suit me. But there are so many other ways of looking at whether the food suited you or not. Example, do you get dry skin? Do you get itchy skin? Do you get dandruff? We always treat the symptom and never the cause. And this is something that I learned, and it has really, now I consciously stay away from mixing salt and milk. Milk traditionally does not need to be mixed with anything else, and that's no fruit, no vegetable, of course, but no fruit, no vegetable, and no spice, no salt. So if you try and practice these four or five simple steps, I think it can be very easy to transform and be more mindful of the way you eat, the way you are, and the way you want to be, most importantly. So if you guys have any questions on these, please feel free to DM me, and I'll be more than happy to help you guys with it. See you guys.